Aha! I bet you didn't see that one coming, the Mavic Mini 2. In this video, I will talk about what I've been able to pick up around the soon to be released Mavic Mini 2. But before we get to that, let's roll that intro. Welcome to another video. I'm Henrik Olsen, and if you want to learn how to make a better video with your drone and camera in general, then consider subscribing to my weekly tips, tests, and tutorials. Last year, around November time, DJI released the Mavic Mini. And only 1 year later, no one really expected they would see an update of the same product. At least not for the Mavic Mini. There's been a lot of rumors about different DJI products that would be launched during 2020. And some of the candidates were the Mavic 3, which is of course the successor to the very popular Mavic 2 series. There's been some discussions about DJI finally taking the step into a ready-to-fly FPV drone. And finally, there's been rumors around an updated version of the Phantom 5. So no one really expected that DJI would actually upgrade the Mavic Mini because it was released only a year ago. When the Mavic Mini was released, it was considered by many a decent upgrade from the previous entry-level drone, the DJI Spark. It was mainly due to the longer flight times, but also the better camera that was now put on a 3-axis stabilized gimbal instead of the 2-axis that you got with the DJI Spark. Because DJI aimed to keep the drone at 249 grams, to avoid that you have to register your drone in most parts of the world to be able to fly it, they had to sacrifice certain things that you got with the DJI Spark. Especially the sensing system that was left out due to this weight limitation was criticized by many as a downgrade compared to the DJI Spark. But in general, people felt like they were getting an upgrade. Despite this as an entry-level drone, there were still a few areas where I felt that the drone was failing short. The 2.7K limitation on a 12 megapixel sensor was sort of a limitation that the DJI has introduced, as we know that this is the same sensor that was put into the original Mavic Pro, so it's definitely capable of doing 4K. Another thing that I thought was really annoying was the connectivity of the drone. I've ran into multiple problems because this is a Wi-Fi drone and it's very prone to be disturbed by Wi-Fi pollution. And finally, it's very sensitive to wind because of the low weight and limited motor power. But all in all, it's still a fantastic product with a reasonable price point that probably have brought many of you into the hobby. So I was a bit surprised when I saw the first rumors surface about an FCC filing where DJI has filed for a FCC certification in the US. And when a company does that, it's normally an indication that they are about to release a new product. Because this application contains information about the actual product, the companies are often delaying this as close as they can to when they plan to release the product. So that's a good indication that a new drone is about to be released. And there are tons of videos out there analyzing on model numbers and stuff like that, going back and forward, concluding that this is the Mavic Mini 2. So I decided to listen to the water pipes, or to my trusted connection that know the industry from the inside, and it's not Osita LV. Even though he has come up with some pretty good stuff lately. But there is a confirmation that this will be the Mavic Mini 2 that will be released. And from what I could pick up, if everything goes well and they are not struck by all sorts of problems, the drone will be available mid-November. And also, I would expect, I haven't been able to confirm that this will replace the original Mavic Mini at the same price point. So what features will you get with this new upgraded model? I think it's absolutely key for DJI to keep the weight at 249 grams. I don't think they will deviate from that strategy because that got this drone into the hands of a lot of you and it is just less hassle flying it because you don't need to register it. So the changes that you will see will fit within the envelope of 249 grams, so they don't need to increase the weight. One thing that I have been able to pick up is that we will get a better camera, and that has also been confirmed by some of the leaked documents that is floating around the web. So they will probably go from 2.7K to 4K, and then will probably also increase the bandwidth from the 40 megabit per second to maybe something like 60 that you saw on the original Mavic Pro. So that will be a really nice bump in quality. The frame rate will probably be capped at 30 frames per second. Because DJI want to keep the weight at 249 grams, I don't think we will see additional sensors on this one. They will also keep the same form factor, so you will still have a very nice little small portable drone, which is one of the things that I really love about the Mini. Also, the battery and the flight time, that will remain the same. But if DJI does what they normally do, is they will make sure that a Mavic 1 battery doesn't fit into a Mavic 2. There has been rumors about a slightly bigger battery, but the difference is so small that it would not mean anything for the flight time. I bet the only reason why they chose another battery is so it's not compatible with your Mavic 1. Because that's one of the areas where DJI they make money, is that you go out, purchase new batteries for your drone instead of reusing your old ones. The FCC document also reveals that the Mavic Mini 2 will contain low power Bluetooth. What do you think the purpose is of including that into the Mini 2? Let me know in the comment below. I saved the best part to the end. The Mavic Mini 2 will be delivered with OcuSync 2.0. And that is super news, because there's nothing like flying an OcuSync drone. It's no matter what you do with the remote, you just still have a rock solid connection. So gone are the days where you have to hack your drone and fiddle around with increasing the broadcast power when you're flying in Europe. So that is really, really good news. And the OcuSync 2.0, that is an argument by itself that will make me buy this drone. I'll probably pick it up anyway. All of this is a mix of stuff that I've been reading on the web, but there are a few things, let me just recap those that I have been able to confirm. The one thing is that you get a better camera. The specs of the camera, that is based on speculation. Also that the drone will be delivered mid-November if everything goes right. You will get OcuSync for the better connection. That one I've been able to confirm as well. The rest is pure speculation from my side. What do you think about the Mavic Mini 2? What to expect? Let me know in the comment below. I read a lot of comments about, I hope the Mavic Mini 2 will support active track. But the Mavic Mini does actually do that. If you're using the Litchi beta app that I've been playing around with lately. In case that you want to see more videos where I've been testing out that app, you can access that through here. I hope you liked this video. If you did, then feel free to give it a like. If you didn't like it, feel free to press the dislike button twice. Thank you for watching, and I'll be seeing you around.